Different mushroom nootropics seem to do different things. Some of them can really help with cognition, some can more so help with fitness and improving your athletic performance. So in this video, I'm gonna talk about the most popular mushroom nootropics so you can better decide which may be appropriate for you. The first being lion's mane mushroom, which I would say is the cognition enhancing nootropic. The second being chaga, which is a mild energy booster. Third would be reishi mushroom. This one is most effective, I think, for immune support. And then the last would be cordyceps, which I call the lung nootropic. It's really useful for those of you who especially are aspiring to have better athletic performance. Let's talk though about lion's mane mushroom. What you'll find when you take lion's mane mushroom is after a couple weeks, you'll suddenly begin to feel a lot more present. You'll begin enjoying your work more. Even your relationships seem a lot better because you're suddenly more interested in people. You'll find that it's easier to connect with people. You'll have a longer attention span. It simply makes everything more interesting. Like if you need to fake an interest in something or somebody, you don't really need to do it anymore. You can think of it like the opposite of anhedonia. With anhedonia, it means a loss of interest. With lion's mane, suddenly you'll have a deeper interest in things. One of the first ways I could tell that lion's mane was working was specifically I'm in sales and I have conversations with people and I would notice like I could learn something interesting from everyone. Due to lion's mane, I had other ideas outside of my typical sales job, like creating this YouTube channel, for instance. And there's no other nootropic I can think that is actually responsible for making you feel smarter to some extent, making you be more interested in people, things, even lengthening your attention span. It helps you to adopt that mindset of delaying gratification versus just looking at the short-term benefits of things like a lot of people do. It's a very different mushroom nootropic than the rest of them. The rest of them seem to help people for general health, which is a reason why I can see other, you can say elder people using the other mushroom supplements. This seems to be effective for everybody, especially those who've had some sort of cognitive impairment, maybe a stroke, maybe some sort of brain injury. Those are the people who sometimes notice this working the most, or even perhaps people who have had a mild or severe depression in the past. There's some evidence showing that lion's mane can help the brain recover in that particular context. So how you'll usually find it is in powder form, sometimes pill. As I mentioned, the coffee before. This is my favorite form. It's the 8-to-1 mushroom extract. I'm taking 300 milligrams three times a day, or sometimes I'm taking 500 milligrams twice per day. Side effects, none you should be concerned of. I haven't had any personally. Some may say that it affects their sleep in a bad way, but if that's the case, then I would recommend you either look at taking a different type of lion's mane, because this is one nootropic where the brand really does matter. All right, now let's look at the next nootropic, and that's chaga. I'm currently taking the mushroom extract from Nootropics Depot. I'm taking 500 milligrams twice per day. It's in Siberia and other parts of Asia. And what it is, it's a fungus that's grown mainly on the bark of birch trees. I've personally not found this nootropic that effective. I probably won't supplement with it anymore. Who this nootropic may particularly be useful for is somebody with, you can say, chronic fatigue or chronic fatigue syndrome. Meaning that they're waking up a little bit tired, maybe they feel tired easily in the day. If there's somebody that is used to feeling energetic for a good 8 to 10 hours, but for some reason something's off and they're getting tired after 5 to 6 hours of the workday, then chaga at a high dose could be worth looking at, because like I mentioned, a lot of people have reported positive effects with improving their energy levels. One of the main issues with this nootropic is that it's pretty expensive, and for some people it doesn't seem to work until about a month. For people who are diabetic, it helps to reduce blood sugar to some extent. It helps to lower cholesterol levels. And there's some studies which actually show that it can help to prevent and even fight cancer. And let's look at the next nootropic, and that would be cordyceps, also known as the lung mushroom. Looking at the benefits, anti-aging, anti-tumor, type 2 diabetes, heart health, inflammation. The common dose of it is 1 gram to 3 grams, and there's a lot of benefits in theory, but in practicality, I've not found cordyceps useful. I've tried it from a number of different brands. I've tried different extracts, tried different dosages. I haven't particularly noticed anything except for maybe a slight improvement in my cardio if I do take it pre-workout. Nothing game-changing though. I've even found like high dose fish oil is something better for improving your cardiovascular skills. But as well, there's a lot of studies actually showing that it does help with athletic performance. However though, they've attempted to show the same results with well-trained individuals, you can say athletes and people who exercise often. And what they found in studies is that when they use cordyceps with those subjects, the individuals did not see any improvements. And that's perhaps why maybe I didn't notice anything from it, is because I'm typically exercising every day, either a light jog or doing some weight training. So cordyceps specifically is not a nootropic which I'm going to use. However though, if you consider yourself to be like a health freak and you want something for general health, then cordyceps is worth looking into. And then the last would be reishi mushroom. And reishi mushroom is especially popular right now. A lot of people are looking for anything they can get their hands on to improve their immune system, given that it's the end of 2020. It's among several medicinal mushrooms that have been used for hundreds of years, mainly in Asian countries, for treatment of infections. Some other benefits include reduced stress, improved sleep, and lessen fatigue. And as far as general health conditions, it seems to help people with high blood pressure, high cholesterol, liver or kidney disease, and even support during chemotherapy. So in the context of nootropics, one thing specifically about reishi mushroom which stood out for me is there's some talk around reishi mushroom being effective at healing the central nervous system. Guys, this is a big deal. A lot of people have taxed their central nervous system. There's a lot of ways you can do that. Stimulants like Adderall, Concerta, Vyvanse, maybe Ritalin, but as well, people who maybe are over-exercising, perhaps you're doing like your one rep max too much, that's really strong on your central nervous system. So if reishi mushroom can help to somewhat recover the central nervous system, then what so is most people should be looking at having better energy levels. They should wake up feeling a little bit more refreshed. They should be more social. So I think there's some promise with this particular nootropic, along with the health benefit, makes it something that perhaps is worth looking into supplementing with. I've tried it several times and I haven't noticed much, but I'm also somebody that doesn't usually get sick. Like I haven't gotten sick for, I think, 8 years. I don't even remember really what a headache feels like. And if you don't believe me, then look at my YouTube channel. You'll see that I upload videos pretty consistently. So reishi mushroom, it hasn't appealed to me specifically. But if we look at this comment here, this individual says they never get flu or colds anymore. And for a common cold, this seems very effective. Some people say after using reishi for 3 or 4 days, their colds are completely gone. As well, some of the positive reviews do say that it helps to reduce irritability. So where I think reishi could work well as far as it being in a nootropic stack is if you're taking something which increases irritability, there's a lot of nootropics that do this. So preparing them with reishi mushroom can, in a practical sense, be very effective. Things like choline or Tongkat Ali or maybe Nupept, these nootropics are known to increase irritability. So in a practical sense, pairing them with some reishi mushroom could really be helpful because then you can enjoy those nootropics without experiencing some of the irritability which can come along with it. To keep this video somewhat brief, we only discussed these 4 nootropics specifically, but I realize there's other mushroom nootropics out there, which I will be discussing in further videos. Things like white jelly, turkey tail, shiitake mushroom, maitake mushroom. So be sure to do me a huge favor, click that subscribe button, click the like button, and comment below as far as your favorite mushroom nootropic. And the way I'm going to end this video is with an insertion of another video I've made on a very popular nootropic called Shilajit, which is not a mushroom. It's a sticky substance found primarily in the rocks of the Himalayas. I like that nootropic a lot. I'm currently taking it. So do check out that video and I'll look forward to seeing you guys next time. Take care, guys. The bottle to only take 250 milligrams once per day. Here's what it looks like. You can't really see. It's like this dark brown kind of texture. Doesn't taste that great. Overall, I would rate this nootropic 7 out of 10, but stay tuned to the end of the video because I'll share with you some